Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. In Jesus, you need Christ in your heart. Christ you can only get in your heart when you realize that this physical body is the temple of God. And the priest sitting in the temple of God is called royal priest or Christ. So that's what Jesus said, you know, before, under the rabbis, you know, they used to worship Yahweh. Yahweh is the demiurge god of nature. So he's alienated, and that was being worshipped to train the natural man to behave morally. But when the rabbi became crook and hypocrite, then the law became useless, because they themselves were not obeying it. How could their disciple obey it? So that's why John the Baptist was the last prophet, as stated by Luke 16, verse 16. Law and the prophet were till John the Baptist, no more after that. After that, you are to be person of spirit, using this temple to worship God in truth and in spirit. So here I give you a good example. In Luke 20, verse 1 onward, the authority of Jesus is challenged. When you preach gospel, then you have to think logically. And when you think logically, then what is derived, what is the nectar, is called logos. And logos sits in your heart. And then you can preach gospel from your own heart with authority. So gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablets of heart. So it is a good example over here. The authority of Jesus challenge. So that's why in Jesus we preach gospel with authority. Not that this man say or that man say or this. No, we speak it from our own heart. With own, our Father is inside us. So he tells us what to say, and we preach it with authority. One day, as Jesus was explaining the roots of the written Torah to the people, which is called teaching of the letters, as the ideal rabbis of the order of the Samaritan villages. Remember, the Samaritan village rabbis, they were good. They were not corrupted as those of the Jerusalem or Judea region rabbis. So they were Samaritan villages were doing in their synagogues to the people in the temple and preaching the gospel as the Samaritan woman had learned from her rabbi. The chief priests, you know, the Jesus was also preaching gospel in the, first he was explaining the roots of the moral laws to the people, basic, and then who were sensible, then he was preaching gospel to them also. And this gospel used to be, is called oral Torah, it used to be with the rabbis, as displayed by the Samaritan woman at the well. She was so well versed in gospel that she waited Jesus in spirit and found him to be a prophet or of highest order. So So the Samaritan woman had learnt the gospel or oral Torah from her rabbi, the chief priests and the scribes with the elders came and said to him, "Tell us by what authority you do these things, or who it is that gave you this authority." Remember that these dog-collar priests that you come across, it's only they are allowed to perform marriage and this and that ceremony, this ceremony. People like me with no dog collar, oh, you have no authority. You have no license. Not allowed. So same way, you know, these Pharisees, or do see, they were having authority from the temple high priest. Who can preach? Who can teach? And they were like university professors, you know, they were enforcers of the law, temple high priest and so and so. So that situation, you should put yourself in that and see what you think. Tell us by what authority you do these things, or who it is that gave you this authority or permission to do so. It is the same thing as the university professor challenge to my interpretation of the New Testament parables, such as the names of the five husbands of the Samaritan woman at the well. So when I tell them the names of the five husbands, because they are well known to in Sikhism, Kaam, Krodh, Lobh, Moh, Ahankar. Kaam mean immorality, Krodh mean anger, Lobh mean greed, Moh mean secular attraction, worldly attraction, and Ahankar mean to be proud of. A man of spirit is not proud of, but a man of letters is, as Simon was proud of, and he invited Jesus to test him. And he did not bother to even greet him by washing his feet. Mary Magdalene came and she greeted him. So five husbands of the Samaritan woman at well, St.Photina was her name, of which they haven't the slightest clue than what this man or the other has written. So they only know, you know, book knowledge that this man has written. Ah, that's good. Whatever he writes, they take him, quote him. If he's a blind guide, and they too are blind guides. He answered them, I also will ask you a question. Now tell me, was the baptism of John in the name of Abraham from heaven or from man? So Jesus reminded them that Abraham baptized Jewish men only in the name, John the Baptist baptized Jewish men only in the name of Abraham. And he baptized Jesus in the name of Yahweh, because his name, Hebrew name, is Yeshua. Yeah, from Yahweh, Shua means Adam, the firstborn of Yahweh, or second Adam, who came floating. But these priests, you know, they have become Jews outwardly. They hated Abraham. That is why they killed Stephen, who went to tell them in the temple how great was their forefather Abraham. Be a son of Abraham. And when he was telling them to be son of Abraham, they were putting fingers in their ears because they don't want to know name of Abraham. And they were making Jews of the people through circumcision only and ritual. Remember, the circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac and his seed. Nobody else can have tribal mark. These Mohammedans having tribal mark of Abraham, which is circumcision from India, you know, ask them, are they Semitic race? They are Aryan race. And there are people from America, Negroes and all that, you know, having this tribal mark. So you can see how stupid the people are. When you have tribal mark, then you say bye-bye to your own tribal father. Then you become only the sons of Abraham. When you say bye-bye to your Aryan father or to Negro father, and then only you become son of the Semitic Abraham of Semitic race. You can't become sons of Abraham by circumcision. Your mother had to be sleep with a man who is the seed of Isaac. I told this thing to a professor in Oxford University. Oh, no. Gentile could be sons of Abraham. So this their chief rabbi, Shaq, I told him too, you know, that a Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. So when you become a Jew outwardly, then you break your covenant with Abraham, become unfaithful to Abraham. No. A Jew is both in of physical self and of heart. How could you have a Jew both spiritual as well as physical? No way. So they cover it up, you know. So don't be frightened of their degrees or of their lordships. Give them a good hiding. Now tell me, was the baptism of John in the name of Abraham from heaven or from man? Remember John the Baptist. He was an ideal rabbi. And he was holding the key to the kingdom of heaven, which the other rabbis did not, because they were hypocrites. So the people believed in him. He was teaching the moral laws, written Torah, to their best ability, because he had the Christ in his heart. So people believed in him, that he is a prophet. And they discussed it with one another, saying, if we say from heaven and from our heavenly father Yahweh, then he will say, why did you not believe him? That is, John the Baptist was the last prophet, Elijah, who came to mend the ways of the temple rabbis. But they were not happy to see him. So they were not happy to see him around, but to die, you know, so that he is no more to criticize them, as they wanted Jesus to die, so that no one there to criticize them or expose their hypocrisy. People who are faithful to Abraham and Yahweh, the salt of the earth, knew that he has come from heaven. So he is come from heaven, and he has the key to the kingdom of heaven, which is in truth. But if we say from man, all the people will stone us to death. for they are convinced that John was a prophet. So this is very important, you know. He was the last prophet on earth. Jesus was not a prophet, nor was Muhammad, nor was Nanak, not Buddha or anyone, you know. So who were they then? So they answered that they did not know where it came from. And Jesus said to them, neither will I tell you by what authority I do these things. Jesus said, why should I tell you? If you are not clean-hearted, you are hypocrites, and you know what is in your mind, but you don't bring it out. So I won't tell hypocrites gospel. Gospel is only for those who are clean-hearted. There are many people who understand what I say, but they pretend, hey, nobody else is telling these things, so why should we believe in him? And they are hypocrites, and they can't have gospel. So our Father God blesses you.